I am so immensely proud.
Hi, how are you? So, I follow an incredibly creative woman by the name of Angelina. She runs a YouTube channel, blueprintdiy. She also has a Facebook group of like-minded upcyclers, of which I am a member. So on the group, there are a lot of people sharing ideas, their own personal projects, as well as giving tips to other members. So somebody posted this image and was basically asking people to help her recreate it. So today we're going to be doing that. But we are going to be making it into a full-on corset. So supplies. I have a pair of denim pants. Actually, I have a lot of pair of denim pants, but for this project, we'll be using one. I'm hoping one will be enough.
You will also need scissors, a sewing machine, tape measure, paper, and a pen and or pencil. If you are just going to make the top as is in the inspiration picture, that's all you're gonna need. But if you want to make the corset, you will also need hook and eye, boning, hand needle, as well as thread, in addition to everything that was stated previously.
So the first thing we're gonna do is to take some measurements. The first measurement is just above your bust, and the second measurement is how long you want the bandeau top to be. So for the back of the bandeau top, we're going to take the measurement we took above our bust and divide it by 2. Then I'm going to add 1.5 inches, just because it's easier to take something in than to add fabric. So for me, that will be 20.5 inches. So that will be the width. So for the length, we measured it, it's 10 inches long. So for the length, I'm also going to add an inch. So I'm going to be cutting a rectangular piece that is 20.5 by 11. So for the front, I really don't know if what I am planning to do is gonna work. I'm really just hoping for the best here. So the piece that she has, the shape of the front is something of this nature. No, something like that. So we're gonna create somewhat of a pattern piece. So we're gonna take our 20.5 by 11 inch measurement, and we're gonna divide that down the middle. So that's gonna be 10.25 by 11 on this side. That's what we're gonna measure on this piece of paper. And now I'm just gonna freehand the shape. So we're going to separate the front and the back first. So the top part of the bandeau top has used the waistband, the front waistband. And if you actually look, they've cut it just below where the belt loop ends. I'm actually hoping that I will be able to use this as the closure. We're gonna cut this band out. So now we have that piece. We're gonna set that aside. Here and along here, of course, with right sides facing each other. Because I want to use this as the closure, I'm going to extend it out a bit, so I'm not going to sew it directly on the edge of this. I'm just going to extend it out a bit. So I tried it on and I've moved both sides in a bit. The distance was much wider, but we're gonna move it in.
Before I sew it, there's a need to make sure it fits. I think I'm gonna move this in some more. I think I'm gonna add a dart of some sort here. So if you just follow that shape and see how it sits. Cutting off the zip. So if your intention was just to make the bandeau top, at this point all you have to do is to add another piece of denim at the bottom of the bandeau top and you can call it a day. However, if you're interested in making the corset top, just keep on watching. Even if you're not interested in making the corset top, just keep on watching. So I've tried it on. We have our darts there. And the back is a bit scrunched.
So talk to my mom, and this is what she told me. We have to contour the back. So we find the middle, and we do 4.5 from the center. That's there. On either side. Now we draw a beautiful line. From this line, on either side, we mark 1/2 inch. And now we're going to create a dart. Now we're gonna sew along that line. So the darts are sewn. Next, we have to reduce the length of the back.
So the top starts somewhere over here. And should end somewhere over there, which is about 8 inches. We have to cut that off. Okay, so let's see how that worked out. Okay, so it scrunches a lot less, and I feel like the rest can be corrected when we add the boning. This is the middle. Thank you.
top of each section where I wanted it to go. I put one in the middle, on the sides, and then in the front. So that was 5 pieces. And I cut them slightly shorter than the length of each section. To sew in the boning, I actually ended up using the seam allowance that was already on the top. And I just sewed the boning into the folds of the seam allowance. For the middle section, it didn't have any seam allowance, so I did follow a tutorial that showed you how to sew boning for that particular predicament. But basically what she did was she took a piece of fabric that was a little bit longer than the boning itself. She sewed the boning onto the edge on the right side of the fabric. She flipped it over, folded the fabric in twice, and then sewed it down onto the corset. So last but not least, I sewed the hooks and eyes onto the front of the corset. I don't know if the dominance of your hand will affect which side you put the hook and which side you put the eye, but for me, I am right-handed, I put the hooks on the right side and the eyes on the left. It's just the most comfortable way for me to put the corset on. When you are sewing the hooks and the eyes on, you want to make sure that they are hidden underneath the clothes and not sticking out. That way when you hook it on, it hooks securely and it's almost invisible. The hook and eyes that I used were fairly large, so I did end up sewing them 1 inch apart. In total, I used 13 of them.
Until next time.